Hi guys, and welcome to this presentation. I'm Anthony.
And I'm Adrian.
Last year, we promoted our fantastic SoccerNet V2 dataset and its challenges. Guess what? We're back. We've got more data, more challenges, and more prizes to win. Are you ready for our major announcement?
Let's go! Nice building, right? Clean, stylish, peaceful. That's not our new office, but it's one of our partners' buildings, EVS Broadcast Equipment, a world leader in sports broadcasting. Recently, we collaborated with them on improving soccer action spotting with camera calibration.
As camera calibration is a hot topic for EVS, we now go one step further with them. On our side, we hired a team of students to annotate all lines on the field. Then, we had to classify them among one of the 20 classes that you see here. So for instance, sidelines, main circle, and all rectangle lines separately.
Also, we asked them to annotate each goal and split it into three parts. Left post, right post, and crossbar, further specifying if they belonged to the left or right goal. In total, more than 30,000 frames were annotated following this process. Let's listen to Florian to know more about the interests of EVS in those annotations.
Hi everyone, I am Florian Magera. I am Innovation Engineer at EVS Broadcast Equipment, and I'm also a PhD candidate at the University of Liège. My research is about the automatic calibration of broadcast cameras in the context of live sports events. This is a topic of great interest for EVS, as we believe that camera calibration is the key to bring augmented reality graphics into any live production. EVS operators can use augmented reality graphics in order to enhance storytelling by helping viewers to get a better understanding of what happened on their screen. And it can also be used in order to increase fan engagement, as you can see with this Carolina Panthers video. But moreover, camera calibration is the link between the image world and the 3D real world, and it can lead to a lot of interesting uses, as you can see with the offside line analysis. This is why I'm very happy to announce that EVS will be sponsoring a camera calibration challenge. The challenge will happen at the CVSports workshop, and it will be divided into two tasks. First, the localization of the soccer pitch elements, in which you will focus on identifying the soccer pitch markings and the goalposts present in the image. Then the second task is the camera calibration. Given an image, you'll have to find valid information about the camera, such as its position, its orientation, and its internal parameters. Check out the SoccerNet GitHub for more details about the challenge and for sample code. Good luck and enjoy.
Awesome. We're so happy to collaborate with you, Florian. Hopefully, we'll get plenty of participants. As for last year's challenges, make sure to join our Discord SoccerNet community to get the latest news. The link is in the description below.
Well, you should know that the 30,000 frames were wisely picked among the videos. Actually, they correspond to action frames and particular frames in their replays. Let's take an example of a goal that was replayed three times in the broadcast video. First, we extract the action frame that was annotated in SoccerNet V2. Then, for each replay associated with this action, we ask the annotator to retrieve the same moment as the action in each replay. This yields four frames showing the same moment but under different viewpoints. From there, we saw an opportunity to annotate all player correspondences across the views, using jersey numbers whenever possible, giving close to 200,000 correspondences.
This setup with a fixed scene and multiple views opens the door to a new challenge. Let's listen to our second partner, Vladimir, from UC Louvain EPFL and Sport Radar, which is another big actor in the sports industry.
Imagine your favorite player running, dribbling, passing, shooting, scoring, and playing the best game of its life. Wouldn't you dream of getting a video made only from the clips showing your beloved superstar? Well, I would. Hello guys, I'm Vladimir Sommers. I spend most of my time on re-identification, so I'm delighted to announce that SportRadar will sponsor a $1,000 competition on this topic. So What's your task? Easy as pie. Given corresponding action and replay frames and player bounding boxes in these frames, try to identify each player across the different camera views. Basically, this means linking the bounding boxes between these video frames from different viewpoints. This task is very useful for player tracking across multiple cameras. For instance, click on a player and get all the frames where he appears. It's challenging, but don't worry. I will walk you through this competition step by step. And who knows, SportRadar might even offer you an internship at the end. Good luck and have fun.
Great. Thanks, Vladimir. This will be a tough task, but we're sure our community will be able to handle it.
All in all, the annotations provided for EVS and SportRadar challenges are part of our brand new paper. Ladies and gentlemen, announcing SoccerNet V3. You can find the paper in the description below and download the data with our pip package. For that, simply type pip install SoccerNet and download the data and annotations with simple Python commands. In the annotation files, you may find a few extras too, such as bounding boxes for the ball and referees, or a team tag for the players. All the details are in the paper. Enjoy!
That being said, it is also good sometimes to build on solid existing work. Last year's challenges were a great success, and some of you already asked us if we would organize them again. Well, you probably remember our colleague Silvio from KAUST. He has a third announcement for you.
Hi Anthony, hi Adrienne, and hi to the SoccerNet community. You don't change a winning team, right? This year, we will renew our challenges on action spotting and replay grounding. As a reminder, action spotting consists in localizing when and which soccer action occurred, in our case among 17 classes, including goals, cards, corners, fouls, and so on. Each action is annotated with a single timestamp, making those annotations quite scattered in those long videos. On the other end, replay grounding focuses on spotting a replayed action in the live game. Although most replays happen within 30 seconds after an action occurs, some actions remain challenging to spot accurately. As you can expect, those tasks can be extremely helpful to generate game highlights automatically, which is definitely a key objective in the research community of sports broadcasts at the moment. Amazing results were obtained and shared last year by Baidu and Hoppo. This year, we'll make this challenge harder and more interesting by tweaking the performance metrics to be more strict. We are focusing now on precise temporal localization for the actions, reducing the tolerance to only a few seconds around the ground truth. Spoiler alert, there is still room for improvement. The performances of the previous submissions decreased significantly and got closer to each other. This year, SportRadar will also sponsor this challenge at CVPR during the ActivityNet workshop. There will be a $1,000 prize shared between the two tasks. Be creative and good luck fighting for the throne.
Fantastic. Thanks, Silvio. Of course, feel free to browse the material provided last year for these tasks. For our new participants, you will find plenty of useful resources in the description to get you started easily.
Now, we've got a final surprise for you. The SoccerNet videos are great, but they are broadcast game, so there are many camera changes and replays. This makes the viewing more dynamic and enjoyable, but for analysis purposes, wouldn't it be great to have a continuous unedited footage? Such data is really rare, but for the first time in soccer research, we managed to get 12 complete games recorded only by the main camera that we will share with the community. It's a true goldmine.
This type of video is the perfect sandbox for a tracking task. So we annotated 200 clips of 30 seconds each with player tracking information, plus a whole uninterrupted 45-minute halftime. And to support this effort, we got help from researchers from a famous company, our former SoccerNet winners, Baidu Research. Let's listen to their announcement.
Hi guys, this is Zhiyu Cheng, a senior researcher at Baidu Research. We are proud to announce our partnership with the SoccerNet team to sponsor a player tracking challenge. In this task, you will have to match the player grounding boxes between consecutive frames.
This creates what is called tracklets in the tracking community. Remark that you don't have to detect players. We already provide the bounding boxes for you, but be aware that if a player leaves a frame and comes back, you will need to re-identify this player in its original tracklet. So taking a look at the re-identification challenge might be worth it for this task.
We will reward the best team with a $1,000 prize. Good luck! We're looking forward to seeing your amazing solutions.
Thank you very much, Baidu team. This is a generous collaboration, and we're excited to organize this challenge with you guys.
All right, it's time for a wrap-up. We've just had four major announcements to keep you busy for the semester. One, we organized a calibration challenge with Florian in collaboration with EVS Broadcast Equipment. Two, we set up a re-identification challenge with Vladimir, sponsored by SportRadar. Three, we renewed the action spotting and replay grounding challenges, but with a tighter metric to force more accurate solutions, also supported by SportRadar. Four, a multiplayer tracking challenge based on new raw games that we release for the community with Baidu Research.
Each challenge has a $1,000 prize, so you can win big if you want to try them all. There is a challenge for every taste, so don't hesitate to come test your bright ideas. The challenges start right now until the end of May. The winners will be announced at CVPR and glorified as deserved. We hope to see you there.
To stay up to date on the upcoming information, join our growing Discord community and follow us on social media. We will soon announce tutorials to help you get started with each challenge and connect with our community. If you want to support us, make sure to leave a like and subscribe to our channel. Don't hesitate to share the news and this video with anyone who could be interested. Thanks for watching and see you next time.